Is Christmas the time of year you look forward to or dread? This month, I'll show you ways of actually enjoying the silly season without the stress. Hi, I'm Josie Thompson. I'm a multi-award-winning coach, mindset and resilience expert, author, and two-time cancer survivor. Today, I'm going to give you some straightforward strategies for surviving Christmas with minimum stress. So let's get started. Tip number one, learn from the season. In the summertime, in the southern hemisphere, it's a time for looser schedules, longer days, more time outdoors, and more frequent travel. While these may be things you've been looking forward to all year round, I know I have, they could also cause annoying changes to our need for rest and stillness. Our natural tendency is to be thrust into a frenzy of parties, shopping, family events, and social responsibilities, all reinforced by the media. So remember, as you're fighting another line at Toys R Us or chatting to another office party member, it's equally important to respect our natural tendencies to take time to pull in and revive to survive Christmas time. Tip number two, take great care of yourself. We can only pour out what's in the cup. In order to be able to give during the holidays, we have to remember to give to ourselves. So take extra good care of yourself to fill your own cup. Take a bath with a candlelight, get a massage, walk in the park or along the beach, ask your partner or a dear friend to hold you. Do whatever it is that makes you feel great. You know what it is. Tip number three, set a budget and stick to it. Our tendency is to overspend at this time of year. In keeping with your commitment to practice extreme self-care, make sure to include your financial well-being as well. Tip number four, choose gifts from the heart. So whether you buy something, make something, write a card, or make a phone call, make that gift from your heart. Slow it down and really mean it. We all crave connection, be it our words or gifts or quality time, physical touch, space, or acts of service. Give the gift that offers love to those that you actually care about in ways that lift them up, and you'll reap much more fulfillment and satisfaction. Tip number five, there is no perfect gift. So gifts are all perfect when they come from your heart. So put some careful thought into your gift giving. Here's a hint, the most priceless gifts don't actually cost money. Tip number six, you can shop early or not. Take a deep breath, make a list, and make where you are okay. Don't wait for those cues. Tip number seven, be fully present where your body is. So whether you're in line at Meijer at 7 o'clock on Christmas Eve or stuck in a traffic jam, make that okay. Just be there and see it all as a gift. Keep your mind where your body is. The frustration that you feel does nothing but hurt you, and so let it go. Ask yourself right now, what is it that you want from the holiday season? What does this season actually mean to you? What are you willing to create? It's actually impossible to actually build something you don't know. So once you know, then take that spirit with you as best as you can, no matter what. Tip number eight, be uncompromisingly selective about who you spend time with. Now, time is valuable. You'll never recover it. So make sure that the people you choose to surround yourself with give you energy and are unconditionally constructive. You deserve it. So limit your time with those who constrict your energy. Tip number nine, Be mindful if you become too hungry, tired, angry, or lonely. So don't push. Any one of these situations can skew your judgment and can make us react. It's like a knee jerk in ways that we may regret later on. So instead, take a deep breath and respond from a place of conscious choice. Tip number 10, do one daily action in your holiday preparations. Anything else is a bonus. For example, if you have 100 festive messages to get done, perhaps your daily action could be to write 10 a day. Anything else is a bonus. So you will be amazed at how quickly you can get through things taken in small chunks like that. And remember to celebrate your accomplishments. I promise to give you something practical in terms of ways of surviving the Christmas with minimum stress. Give them a try and let me know how you go. If you have other ideas for surviving Christmas with less stress, please share them below. If you're thinking of a special gift for that hard-to-buy for a loved one, consider gifting them membership to my exclusive inner tribe at Coffee, Tea and Josie. Your loved one will be resourced with practical life strategies to live a fuller, healthier, joyful and more empowered life. So here's a Christmas deal you won't want to miss. There are some other gifting ideas that you can also check out over at josiethompson.com. Happy shopping. Until next time, remember this. It's not what happens to you that defines you. It's how you respond that counts. Shine on. Thank you.